So in this we'll discuss about the second protocol, which is so called as stop and wait protocol. This is a connection oriented protocol which uses both flow and error control. So the sender and the transmitter, both of them, the sender and the receiver, use a sliding window of size 1. Sender and receiver both use a sliding window of size 1. The sender sends one packet at a time and waits for an acknowledgement before sending the next one. Then, to detect the corrupted packets, we need to add a checksum to each data packet. When a packet arrives at the receiver side, it is checked. If its checksum is incorrect, packet is corrupted and silently discarded. So this diagram is going to illustrate the stop and wait protocol. You can see here logical channels. Then you can see there is a timer. You can see send window, next packet to receive, receive window. You can see and all packet sequence number, checksum, acknowledgement, acknowledge, checksum and all. Okay, so the silence of the receiver is a signal for the sender that the packet was either lost or corrupted, meaning that the sender needs to keep a copy of the packet was either lost or corrupted. What does this mean is that the sender needs to keep a copy of the packet until its acknowledgement arrives. So every packet should be acknowledged by the receiver. So this diagram is going to show the outline of the stop and wait protocol. It is a connection oriented protocol. Then only one packet and one acknowledgement can be in the channels at any time. So at a time there has to be only one acknowledgement and only one packet in the channel at any time. So this stop and wait protocol, it provides flow and error control. Okay, next we'll discuss about sequence number. This protocol uses sequence numbers and acknowledgement numbers. Okay, so a field is added to the packet header to hold the sequence number of that packet. This one important consideration is that the range of sequence number. Then when we want to minimize the packet size, there is a need to look for the smallest range that provides unambiguous communication. So we'll discuss the range of sequence numbers we need. Now let us assume that we have used x as a sequence number. We only need to use x plus 1 after that. There is no need for x plus 2. Assume that the sender has sent the packet with sequence number x. Then three things will happen. What are the three things will happen? We'll see. Three things will happen. First one, the packet arrives safe and sound at the receiver site. Okay, the packet arrives safe and sound at the receiver site. The receiver sends an acknowledgement. Then that acknowledgement arrives at the sender side, causing the sender to send the next packet numbered x plus 1. So this packet is corrupted or never arrives at the receiver side. The sender resends the packet numbered x after the timeout. So once the timeout is out, the packet may be corrupted or never arrives at the receiver. The sender resends the packet numbered x after the timeout. The receiver returns an acknowledgement. Third is, the packet arrives safe and sound at the receiver side. The receiver sends an acknowledgement, but the acknowledgement is corrupted or lost. So then what happens is the sender resends a packet numbered x after the timeout. Note that the packet here is a duplicate. The receiver can recognize this fact because it expects packet X plus 1, but packet X was received. Okay, so these are the things that will happen. Okay, then what we can see is that there is a need for sequence numbers X and X plus 1 because the receiver need to distinguish between case 1 and case 3. There is a need for a packet to be numbered X plus 2. In case 1, packet can be numbered X again because packets X and X plus 1 are acknowledged and there is no need of ambiguity at either side. In case 2 and 3, new packet is X plus 1, not X plus 2. If only X and X plus 1 are needed, we can let X is equal to 0 and X plus 1 is equal to 1. What is this meaning is that the sequence is 0, 1, 0, 1, 0 and so on. So this is referred to as modulo 2 arithmetic. Okay, acknowledgement numbers. Acknowledgement number. So whatever are the sequence numbers, they must be suitable for both data packets and acknowledgement. The acknowledgement number always announces the sequence number of the next packet expected by the receiver. For example, if packet 0 has arrived safe and sound, receiver sends an acknowledgement with acknowledgement 1. What is the meaning is that packet 1 is expected next. If packet 1 has arrived safe and sound, receiver sends an acknowledgement with packet 0, meaning that packet 0 is expected. So why it is 0 is, what is the sequence is? Sequence is given as 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. It is referred, it is modulo 2 arithmetic. Then in the stop and wait protocol, acknowledgement number always announces in modulo 2 arithmetic sequence number of the next packet expected. Okay.